Welcome back, students. We continue with our maths 2 trigonometry. We continue with practice set 6.1. The seventh sum, sine raised to 4 theta minus cos raised to 4 theta is equal to 1 minus 2 cos square theta. That means we have to prove the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So we consider the left hand side, sine raised to 4 theta minus cos raised to 4 theta. Sin raised to 4 theta can be written as sin square theta whole square, and cos raised to 4 theta can be written as cos square theta whole square. So we have sin square theta square minus cos square theta square. So it's of the form a square minus b square. Here a is sin square theta and b is cos square theta. So according to the identity, a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. We have sin square theta square minus cos square theta square is equal to sin square theta plus cos square theta into sin square theta minus cos square theta. We also know the identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So we substitute 1 in place of sin square theta plus cos square theta. So we have this is equal to 1 into sin square theta minus cos square theta. So 1 multiplied by any number is the same number. So we have this is equal to sin square theta minus cos square theta. Again, we have the same identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So taking cos square theta on the other side, it becomes minus cos square theta. So we have sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. So we substitute in place of sin square theta 1 minus cos square theta. So we have 1 minus cos square theta minus cos square theta. So cos minus cos square theta minus cos square theta, these are the similar terms, so we can add them. So this will give us minus 2 cos square theta. So this is equal to 1 minus 2 cos square theta. This is our right hand side, that is 1 minus 2 cos square theta. So we have left hand side is equal to right hand side. It is proved that sin raised to 4 theta minus cos raised to 4 theta is equal to 1 minus 2 cos square theta. Eighth sum, to prove that sec theta plus tan theta is equal to cos theta upon 1 minus sin theta, the left hand side is sec theta plus tan theta. Now we want the right hand side in terms of cos and sin. So we substitute sec and tan in terms of cos and sin. Sec theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. So sec theta is 1 upon cos theta, and tan theta is sin theta upon cos theta. So here the denominators are same, cos theta and cos theta. So we add the numerators. So we have 1 plus sin theta upon cos theta. We write only once. This 1 plus sin theta upon cos theta, we multiply the numerator and denominator by 1 minus sin theta. So the numerator is of the form a plus b, a minus b. That is 1 plus sin theta into 1 minus sin theta. That is a square minus b square. So that will give us the numerator as 1 square minus sin square theta. Upon the denominator we write as it is, that is cos theta into 1 minus sin theta. 1 square is 1. So numerator is 1 minus sin square theta, that is cos square theta. So this is equal to cos square theta upon cos theta into 1 minus sin theta. Cos theta is multiplied to the full bracket 1 minus sin theta. Okay, so cos theta, since it is multiplied, we can reduce it with the numerator. So 1 cos theta from the numerator is reduced with cos theta from the denominator. So in the numerator we have cos theta, in the denominator we have 1 minus sin theta. So this is equal to cos theta upon 1 minus sin theta. This is equal to our right hand side. Okay, so left hand side is equal to right hand side is proved. Therefore we have sec theta plus tan theta is equal to cos theta upon 1 minus sin theta. ninth one. If tan theta plus 1 upon tan theta is equal to 2, then show that tan square theta plus 1 upon tan square theta is equal to 2. Now in this sum, we don't have to prove left hand side is equal to right hand side, but we are given one full relation and we have to prove another relation based on the given relation. So we are given the relation tan theta plus 1 upon tan theta is equal to 2. And we have to prove tan square theta plus 1 upon tan square theta is equal to 2. So since tan theta plus 1 upon tan theta is equal to 2, this is given to us. To get tan square theta, we square both the sides. So squaring both the sides, we have tan theta plus 1 upon tan theta whole square is equal to 2 square. Now when we square the left hand side, tan theta plus 1 upon tan theta, this is one full term. So the full term has to be squared. We cannot write tan square theta plus 1 upon tan square theta. We have to take tan theta plus 1 upon tan theta whole square. Okay. So now the left hand side, tan theta plus 1 upon tan theta whole square, it is in the form of the identity A plus B whole square. So we have A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. So we write the identity on the left hand side. So we have tan square plus 2 into tan theta into 1 upon tan theta plus 1 upon tan square theta is equal to 4. So in the middle term, tan theta and 1 upon tan theta, this will cancel each other. So we have tan square theta plus 2 plus 1 upon tan square theta is equal to 4. Now we take 2 on the other side. So we have tan square theta plus 1 upon tan square theta is equal to 4 minus 2. When we change the side, the sign changes. So plus 2 on the other side will become minus 2. So therefore we have tan square theta plus 1 upon tan square theta is equal to 2. This is what we had to prove. Tenth sum, to prove that tan A upon 1 plus tan square A whole square plus cos A upon 1 plus cot square A whole square is equal to sin A into cos A. So here again we have to prove left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we take the left hand side and try to simplify it. So left hand side is tan A upon 1 plus tan square A whole square plus cot A upon 1 plus cot square A whole square. Here instead of theta, they have taken the angle as A. Okay. So we have 1 plus tan square A is sec square A according to the identity, and 1 plus cot square A is equal to cosec square A. So we substitute. So we have tan A upon sec square A whole square plus cot A upon cosec square A whole square. So sec square A whole square will give us sec raised to 4A, and cosec square A whole square will give us cosec raised to 4A. So we have tan A upon sec raised to 4A plus cot A upon cosec raised to 4A. Now tan A upon sec raised to 4A means tan A is divided by sec raised to 4A. And cot A upon cosec raised to 4A means cot A is divided by cosec raised to 4A. Okay, so we have tan A as sin A upon cos A divided by, in place of sec raised to 4, we write 1 upon cos raised to 4A plus cot A is written as cos A upon sin A divided by cosec raised to 4A is written as 1 upon sin raised to 4A. So this is equal to, as studied earlier, division by a number means multiplication by its reciprocal. So this division we convert into multiplication. So the first term, sin A upon cos A, we write as it is. Division becomes multiplication, and we take the reciprocal of the second term. So 1 upon cos raised to 4A will be written as cos raised to 4A upon 1 plus, in the second bracket, the first term cos A upon sin A as it is, division will become multiplication, and 1 upon sin raised to 4A will become multiplied by sine raised to 4a. Now we reduce. In the first bracket, cos raised to 4a in the numerator and cos a in the denominator. So 1 cos a we can reduce. So in the numerator we will have cos cube a, and in the second bracket sin a in the denominator and sin raised to 4a in the numerator. So in the numerator 1 sin a will reduce. So we will have sin cube a. So in the first bracket we have sin a multiplied by cos cube a, plus in the second bracket we have cos a multiplied by sin cube a. So that is equal to sin a multiplied by cos a into cos square a plus sin square a. That is equal to sin a multiplied by cos a, and cos square a plus sin square a will give us 1. So that is equal to sin a multiplied by cos a. So this is equal to our right hand side. So hence it is proved that left hand side is equal to right hand side. So therefore we have tan a upon 1 plus tan square a whole square plus cot a upon 1 plus cot square a whole square is equal to sin a multiplied by cos a. 11th, sec raised to 4a into 1 minus sin raised to 4a minus 2 tan square a is equal to 1. So here also we have to prove left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we consider the left hand side, sec raised to 4a into 1 minus sin raised to 4a minus 2 tan square a. Now sec raised to 4a is multiplied to the bracket 1 minus sin raised to 4a. So we have to multiply sec raised to 4a in sec raised to 4a to both the terms in the bracket. So we have sec raised to 4a into 1, that is sec raised to 4a, minus sec raised to 4a into sin raised to 4a minus 2 tan square a. Sec raised to 4a is 1 upon cos raised to 4a minus, again sec raised to 4a is 1 upon cos raised to 4a into sin raised to 4a minus 2 into tan square a is written as sin square a upon cos square a. So that is equal to 1 upon cos raised to 4a minus, now 1 upon cos raised to 4a into sin raised to 4a can be written as sin raised to 4a upon cos raised to 4a minus 2 sin square a upon cos square a. Now in the first two terms they have this common denominator, so we can write the numerator together. So we have 1 minus sin raised to 4a upon cos raised to 4a minus, the second term we write as it is, 2 sin square a upon cos square a. Now sin raised to 4a can be written as sin square a whole square. So it is written as 1 minus sin square a whole square upon cos raised to 4a minus the second term as it is, 2 sin square a upon cos square a. Now if you take the numerator of the first term, 1 minus sin square a whole square, it's of the form 1 is a square of 1, so it's of the form a square minus b square. So we write it as a plus b into a minus b, that is 1 plus sin square a into 1 minus sin square a upon, the denominator is cos raised to 4a, minus the second term 2 sin square a upon cos square a, we write as it is. So this is equal to 1 plus sin square a as it is, 1 minus sin square a is equal to cos square a from the identity sin square a plus cos square a is equal to 1 upon cos raised to 4a minus 2 sin square a upon cos square a as it is. So in the first term, cos square a upon cos raised to 4a can be reduced. So in the denominator 2 cos square a will be reduced. So in the denominator we will have cos square a. So we have 1 plus sin square a upon cos square a minus 2 sin square a upon cos square a. Now both the denominators are equal again. So we write the numerator together. It is 1 plus sin square a minus 2 sin square a upon, the common denominator is written once, cos square a. Now sin square a minus 2 sin square a, again these are similar terms, so we can add them. So plus sin square a means plus 1 sin square a minus 2 sin square a. So plus 1 minus 2 will give us minus 1 sin square a. So that this is equal to 1 minus sin square a upon cos square a. Now 1 minus sin square a is equal to cos square a upon, the denominator is also cos square a. So we can reduce it, cos square a divided by cos square a is equal to 1. This is our right hand side which we had to prove. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So sec raised to 4a into 1 minus sin raised to 4a minus 2 tan square a is equal to 1. 12th one. To prove that tan theta upon sec theta minus 1 is equal to tan theta plus sec theta plus 1 upon tan theta plus sec theta minus 1. Here we can, even if we take any one side, okay, we cannot directly prove the second side as equal. So here, instead of starting with any side, for example, starting with the left hand side or starting with the right hand side, we start with the identity that we know and we try to deduce the left hand side from the identity. Okay, so we have an identity related to tan theta and sec theta, that is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. So tan square theta will be sec square theta minus 1. We are taking plus 1 on the other side. So tan square theta is written as tan theta into tan theta. That is equal to sec square theta minus 1. It is in the form of the identity a square minus b square. So it is a plus b into a minus b. That is sec theta plus 1 into sec theta minus 1. Okay, so now we bring sec theta minus 1 on the left hand side. Okay, when we do that, we will get the left hand side of our given equation. So we have tan theta upon sec theta minus 1 is equal to, this tan theta we take on the other side, we have is equal to sec theta plus 1 upon tan theta. So now if you see, we have got the left hand side of our equation, which is given to us, tan theta upon sec theta minus 1. So here we use the theorem on equal ratios, okay, which you have already studied in a 9th standard. You can add the ratios by theorem on equal ratios. We will have tan theta upon sec theta minus 1 is equal to sec theta plus 1 upon tan theta is equal to, we add the numerators now, that is tan theta plus sec theta plus 1 upon, we add the denominator sec theta minus 1 plus tan theta. So this is by the theorem on equal ratios. So therefore we prove that tan theta upon sec theta minus 1 is equal to tan theta plus sec theta plus 1 upon tan theta plus sec theta minus 1. Here we come to the end of the practice set 6.1. Students, kindly learn all the identities thoroughly. Kindly learn the table where all the values for different angles are given and practice the sums regularly. You can do the following sums for your practice in your maths notebook. Thank you, and we shall continue with the chapter in the next video.